Financial Reporting Web Studio is a web-based report authoring solution to design, preview, and manage reports for the following services: planning, financial consolidation and close, profitability and cost management, and tax reporting. With the Cloud EPM Platform Reporting Solution, you can design reports with grids, charts, text boxes, and images. You can launch Financial Reporting Web Studio from these locations. In EPM Workspace, from the Tools menu, click the Launch Reporting Web Studio menu item. In EPM Cloud, go to Navigator. Under Reporting, click Reporting Web Studio. I'll expand folders and open a report. Notice there are menu options and a toolbar. The repository pane contains folders and reports I can edit. You can use the search toolbar to search and filter results. The summary pane displays information for the opened report, such as the report name and description. While editing a report, I have an object browser where I can select individual objects that are currently in the report. Selecting the report node returns you to the design canvas. Here is the design canvas where I can lay out report objects. I can insert or delete objects, resize, or move them around. On the right side, we have the properties pane, which displays specific properties for the report or the object that is currently selected. Now I'll create a report. You design reports by starting with a blank report layout, where you specify the contents of the report, including grids, charts, images, text boxes, headers, and footers. You create a report by adding objects to the design canvas in Financial Reporting Studio. I can insert objects using the Insert menu or the toolbar. I can also insert objects using the Object Browser. Let me show you. I'll add a grid to the report body. As soon as I add the grid, it prompts for a database connection. Enter and verify your selections before proceeding. With the dimension layout, you assign dimensions to a report axis, such as POV, page, row, or column. After assigning dimensions, grid properties is displayed with accordion-style sections. You can expand or collapse sections in Report Designer. When designing a report, hiding sections expands the design area that you can work with. Next, I'll select members. I can select members individually or use Function Selector. I can choose to display selections in separate columns or rows. You can select members for your reports by using lists that are located on the Lists tab. You can select a function as a member for your report and then assign specific values to the function parameters. You can switch to Advanced Mode, where you can work with operators and exclusions. You can reorder items in the list, edit them, or preview your selection. Let's view our selections on the grid. You can move or resize the grid on the design canvas. I'll make quick selections for my row dimension. Next, I'll set some basic formatting options using the toolbar. You can apply more cell formatting options using the Format menu or right-click menu. The Format Cells dialog box includes most advanced cell formatting options. I'll add a bottom border to the columns. I'll add a few more objects to my report. I'll add a title and image in the header area. You can insert text functions in your text box as well. You can set chart properties, such as the chart type. When finished, save your report. I'll preview my report. The report preview is opened in a separate window. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.